world of CDPs, explore why they exist, and explore why and how AI can serve as a replacement and enhancement for CDP systems for any organization overall. So if you're not familiar with CDPs, why they exist and what they are and what they do, essentially they take records across like multiple different systems and they tie them together. And then so for, let's say, like a retailer, like a big like retail company or a big company overall, you generally, you have records or people from like in multiple different systems, and oftentimes you don't have like a clean way to tie those records together, right? Like maybe one system has like a different phone number, different address, different characteristics about the different person, people overall. And then so that makes it really hard overall to join those particular records. And then so that particular problem is a common problem among companies and corporations overall. But that particular problem also happens to be a very, very, very difficult problem overall for general classical computers to solve. And then just highlighting and illustrating up front kind of why that's the case. You can see here, my goal is to not overwhelm you with code. But so starting off, what we're looking at here is these two example records. So what I'm highlighting here, right here, just these two example records here. And then so what we can see within these records is that they're like almost the same, right? The only difference is that it's J-O-H-N for the first name compared to J-O-N. And then it's age of 30 and 32. Those are the only two differences in these records. Other than that, they're 100% identical. And then so what this code is doing is, so there's a few different iterations and a few different versions of this code that I've built out. And then so this first version and the version in the bottom that we're looking at here is my kind of like very first crack at, so what this does is it's like rule-based, and then it uses simple machine learning logic. So this is using SKFuzzy and a system called FuzzyWuzzy to essentially determine the similarity between these two records. And then so it determines a similarity score. And then the similarity score in this instance is there's a low, medium, and a high. And then in this particular instance with these two records, with those two differences, the J-O-N compared to J-O-H-N, and then the 30 to 32, it scores a match confidence of 0.5, like 50%. So like not high overall, right? Like, so it's like just with these two differences within the code overall, like the system is not, it's not very confident at all that these two records are related. Like this is a hard challenge overall for a computer to understand. Like it just doesn't understand what is going on with these types of equations, right? Like it's like, well, it's just too confusing. John is not John, right? The J-O-N is not J-O-H-N, and one is 30 and one is 32, so they're not the same overall. And so 50% is what the overall confidence score is there. And then so from there, I decided, well, like, let's see what would happen, and I kind of made more complex logic. And then so the more complex logic here is very simple, like combining rule-based systems with LLMs. And then so I've been experimenting around a lot with that, and then so this was kind of my first attempt at that. And then so how this works is essentially it goes through and then it will give the LLM model the score, and then based off of the score and then the record, then the LLM model will make its determination. And then what I found here is that the problem was that like this score, this 50%, was like dragging down significantly the LLM model's response in this instance, because it wants to say that they're not related because the rules-based system is giving it 50%. And then so the LLM model then applies a lot of weight to that 50% and says, no, that they're not related at all. So from there, I went through and I updated the code to essentially rule out that don't give the model that 50% up front, and then just give it the two records and then see what happens. And then in that instance, I give the model the records, and then it still gives the same feedback that no, the two records aren't related to each other. what way I slice this occasion. Says that they're not the same person. Although both records have the same email and address, the first record has John as the first name and John as the last name, while the second record has John as both the first name and last name. Therefore, they represent different individuals. So this gives you kind of overall a good sense as to how exactly the LLM model is going to treat this particular example, right, and what it's going to do with this particular situation. And so overall, with these models, I tested it on the very first test that I tried with these models was a tiny llama. I couldn't actually get any result back. I thought, like, I wanted to start really small and see if I could actually get some sort of, like, response back, an incremental response. And then my next step up is Kian Mini, which is, on par with, Phi models. And then from here, I stepped up to, I experimented more along this question, right, after I wanted to determine and figure out what was going on here, and I thought it was interesting. So with further experimentation, I went to Llama 7B, and it was the same thing, no. And then I went to Quinn 70B, so 70 billion parameter model, and then at 70 billion parameters, it was like, yes, like, you know, they're related, and then so I could get what I wanted. And so I said, okay, maybe I can scale it back down. So I couldn't use Llama 2 7B, but maybe I could use like Mistral 7B. So I tried Mistral 7B, and Mistral 7B was able to give us the answer that we're looking for. So kind of what I was able to determine through my experimentations with all of that is that you can 100% utilize LLM model as your CDP within your system, right, overall. And it would be able to recognize these differences far better than any other computer program that I've ever dealt with. Within these two types of situations, again, because the normal computer program that you deal with, it's going to give you 50% that these two records are related, right? Just because how it works, like it's going to treat how these small LLM models are, where it's giving it like this type of accuracy rating overall. But once you step up to 7B, then it's able to correlate, and it'll say, you know, like, yeah, they're the same, like John and John. So if you then put an LLM model at the center of, like a 7B model at the center of this, you'd actually get them to correlate into match. So you get match confidence, like, you know, closer to 100%, which is exactly what you would want there. And then, so that was kind of my overall test within this is, would LLM models be a good overall replacement for CDP systems? And then my initial logic was, and why I started off with these very small models is, my initial logic was that, yes, LLM models would be a very good replacement for CDP models, because that's exactly what LLM models are built on, right? They're prediction models, and then they're built on, like, NLP, natural language processing. So their core is about, like, predicting things, and then predicting things via language. So that's exactly what this is. Like, so an LLM model could handle that better than any CDP on the planet overall, these results bear that out. This point of this video is to illustrate this overall. And then if you know what you're doing as far as the code, and that's kind of what we're looking at here with all of this code, it's really simple to integrate this into your systems, right? So if I wanted to integrate an LLM model and pass through checks to see my records and then check my records and join my records via the LLM input and make any... if I want to put rules on top of that, or I want it to not actually execute, or any sort of logic that I want to put into that, I can put all of that into the code here as well, and then get essentially anything that I would want overall as far as like my ideal CDP. So from my opinion and from going through these tests, what it kind of shows to me overall is like there's really no reason overall to have CDP systems where LLM models can definitely like step in and handle that far better than the status quo, and far better than deterministic software overall. So if you're paying for CDP and you know how to code, I'll leave you a description to this Google Colab notebook, and feel free to go to town and adjust the notebook and anything that you would want within there. It's everything that you would need in order to essentially, you know, like replicate this and do anything that you would want that's like CDP and LLM related. And then so hope you like this type of content, and if you do, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much.